We're focusing on the latest assault from Arvind Kejriwal, and this time he's trained his guns at one of the biggest names in Indian industry, Mukesh Ambani. What Arvind Kejriwal is saying as he takes on Mr. Ambani as well as Veerappa Moily and Murali Deora is that he's accusing the government and Reliance of colluding in inflating gas prices, that's his charge, to make windfall gains. The Delhi Chief Minister has gone to the extent of saying that now he is ordering FIRs, in other words, criminal cases, to be launched against Mr. Ambani, Mr. Moily and Mr. Deora. Veerappa Moily has hit back. He's called Arvind Kejriwal ignorant and says he doesn't understand how a government works. Reliance is also calling the allegations shocking and baseless, and its warning of legal action. It's also raising the question of conflict of interest, saying one of the members of the Aam Aadmi Party is also a petitioner in this case in the Supreme Court. On the program today, are these charges substantive or are they slanderous? And as Arvind Kejriwal continues to, in a sense, look to make one big announcement after another at his press conferences, is this politics by press conference out-of-the-box thinking or is it simply outrageous and outlandish? That's our question on the Buck Stops here tonight. Let's introduce our panel this evening. We're joined by Prashant Bhushan. He is, of course, a senior member of the Aam Aadmi Party. He is also in the Supreme Court, involved in this case against Reliance. With me in the studio is Sohail Seth. He's the managing partner with Consulage. Also joining me from Bangalore tonight is Captain Gopinath. He's a member of the Aam Aadmi Party and also a well-known industrialist. This coming on a day when FICCI and other chambers of commerce are accusing the Aam Aadmi Party of creating a trust deficit with industry. Is that charge valid, or is the Aam Aadmi Party taking on what they call crony capitalism? And we'll also be joined shortly by Vikram Mehta. Vikram Mehta, I can see him there. Vikram Mehta, the chairman of Brookings India, but also the former chairman of the Shell Group of companies. Prashant Bhushan, let me start with you. We've just got in the last 30 minutes the statement from Reliance Industries, and it is calling the charges made by your chief minister shocking. It's calling them baseless, but it's also asking why you simply couldn't wait for this case to unfold in the Supreme Court. It's perhaps pointing at you when it says that one of the petitioners in this case is also a member of the Aam Aadmi Party, alleging thereby your agenda spilling over onto the politics of your party. Your response?
Well, this whole gas issue is not just the biggest scam in independent India. It's a series of scams in which not merely the present government has been involved, but the previous governments have also been involved.
You mean
and
the BJP?
That is why
are
all
you including
the
BJP
governments?
In that?
Yes, 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 absolutely, absolutely, the BJP as well. And that is why, because all of them have been in collusion with Reliance on this issue, nobody from the Congress nor from the BJP, at least to the credit of the Congress party, there were two ministers in the Congress, Manishankar Iyer as well as Jaipal Reddy, who tried to do whatever they could do to stop this rampant loot. But unfortunately, both of them were shunted out unceremoniously and replaced by not just pliable but by corrupt ministers in their place who colluded with Reliance and undid whatever was being done by Manishankar Iyer as well as Jaipal Reddy.
But Mr. Bhushan, why couldn't you wait for the Supreme Court? I mean, the question raised by RIL in its statement and even by other senior lawyers like Rajiv Dhawan, for example, today, the question being raised by them is the case is in court. The hearing is going to be in the first week of March. Why should the Aam Aadmi Party declare people innocent or guilty? You are not a court. The court is the Supreme Court. So shouldn't this be the job of the Supreme Court, Mr. Bhushan?
So why is this case in court? The case is in court because the governments were not doing anything at all. Nobody had even bothered to register an FIR in the matter.
Okay.
Because all those governments and the agencies controlled by them were in collusion with Reliance.
Okay.
In one case, the Supreme Court, connected with the Radia Tapes matter, ordered an FIR to be registered into the appointment of the Director General of Hydrocarbons and his actions in allowing this huge price increase and gold plating of costs by Reliance, which is merely one of the scams involved in this whole Reliance gas issue.
Okay.
There are five scams involved in this.
May I come
first,
back to you?
Okay. When their cost was under, just one minute.
Okay.
When their cost was under $1, they were allowed first to charge, to increase the cost from 2.34, which they themselves had bidded in an open tender with NTPC for 17 years, from 2.34 to 4.20 by Mr. Murali Devra when he was the minister.
Yes.
Thereafter, they were allowed to drop their production from 80 units to 14 units.
Okay.
And no penalty was imposed upon them. The penalty proposed by Jaipal Reddy was withdrawn by Mr. Moily.
Let me just
thereafter, they were allowed to retain 95% of their leasehold area, which they ought to have surrendered. They were allowed to retain that. And thereafter, this price has been increased from 420 to 840.
Okay, now,
I mean, which means an outgo of 54,000 crores a year.
I know, we've seen that in the statement.
Pockets of the people
who
will be paying higher fertilizer prices, higher gas prices, higher power prices, and all this 54,000 crores of windfall profits will go annually to Reliance.
You made a number
What can be a bigger scam than this?
Okay, you made a number of very grave allegations. I think it's only fair we now give the others a chance to respond to this. Sohail, Mr. Bhushan is detailing his allegations, and he is saying that, look, the fact of the matter is that all governments have colluded with one of the biggest industrial houses in this country. Do you believe that there is a substance to these allegations? Do you believe that, given that the left parties, for example, and there's a letter from Gurudas Dasgupta also to this effect, have come out today in support of the Aam Aadmi Party, which they otherwise don't necessarily praise all the time, makes this into a very a grave moment in terms of the debate around what the Aam Aadmi Party calls crony capitalism?
Okay, I don't want to take truck with Prashant Bhushan. I mean, these are matters that he is discussing the Supreme Court.
Yeah.
We've now converted Delhi into where everything will be held out in public, you know. Courts will be held in public, assemblies will be held in stadia. So I don't want to get into that nonsense. But let me just make a couple of points from what I've read. Number one, 15% is what is Reliance's contribution or take in the oil and gas business.
Yeah.
85% belongs to government and other public sector and other private sector companies. So if you have to target everyone. If you do substantive analysis of everything that Prashant has also rightly said, as of date, the Indian government is spending about 14 to 16, max 19 US dollars per MMBTU. Mm. So what is happening? I'm not justifying price A or price B. That's not my business.
You're saying let the court decide.
No,
that.
I'm saying if we are already spending a huge chunk of valuable foreign exchange, sacrificing our energy security, then scaring away any private enterprise, be it Reliance, be it private company X, be it a joint sector, what kind of country are we going to build? A, B, is Arvind Kejriwal the only honest human being on the planet? No. The committee was Rangarajan committee. Why haven't you filed an FIR against Rangarajan? It was a cabinet decision that was taken. File an FIR against every member of the cabinet because I've been told in democracy, it's collective responsibility. So it's not about defending one or the other. I'm saying that if you want to make a cogent argument, then don't keep crying wolf every time, because two things will happen. Number one, you will hit at the industry that is actually trying to contribute.
Okay.
Number two, you will create allegations which are not substantial.
So you're saying Reliance is being singled out for attack by the Aam Aadmi Party?
I'm not only talking about Reliance, I'm saying even the private sector. I mean, Prashant knows this. You know, now he talks about five scams. I'm saying there must have been 100 scams. You want to blame every government, you might as well blame Lord Mountbatten. So this argument is non-tenable. It doesn't cut. And most importantly, this is not the way I would imagine a person like Arvind Kejriwal, who's perhaps rightly crusading against corruption, is going to have a case that is believable.
Okay, many strong rebuttals coming there from Sohail, and I will take them back to Prashant Bhushan tonight. But Vikram Mehta, as somebody who understands this sector, and it is an extremely technical debate, what we want to explain to our viewers today is What is this controversy all about? Do you believe that when the left, for example, gets up and raises questions about it, that Gurudas Dasgupta has written a letter on this? Do you believe that as Prashant Bhushan details the allegations, do you believe this is about trust deficit with industry, or do you believe this is about crony capitalism? Because let me share with you, and Prashant, you could also react to this later, the statement that has just come in from Fiki, saying a great degree of care and responsibility is needed in revisiting decisions. If a needless trust deficit between industry, correct, government and society is to be avoided, which can only vitiate business and investment sentiment. Vikram, go ahead.
Yeah, look, I've heard what Prashant Bhushan has said, and I'm no politician, I'm no apologist for any industry, but I have to say that the kind of allegations that have just been leveled make absolute no sense to me. I've been in this industry for 35 years, and not one word that has been said by Prashant Bhushan can be substantiated either technically, economically, or legally. Now, I could talk about it at length, of course I won't, but let's just put two or three things on the table right up front. One is that unlike oil, there is no world gas price. The price of gas in the US is $4 a million BTU, the price of gas in Europe is around $8, the price of gas in Japan, Asia Pacific is between $14 and $16 a million BTU. What Rangarajan committee has done is take a weighted average of those prices and decided that $8 a million BTU is a fair price. Now they could have decided upon a different formula, they could have looked at the consumers of gas and said the formula should be based on a weighted average of the consumers. Okay. Now there again you would have had different prices. A power company that was using liquid fuels would be currently paying around $19 to $20 a million BTU for running its power plant. It would be more than happy to substitute that with gas at say $15. A power plant, however, run on coal would be reluctant to pay more than $4 to $5 a million BTU.
Okay.
A fertilizer plant would be happy to build a domestic fertilizer plant in India at $8 a million BTU. So a weighted average of that would also come to around $8 a million BTU. So insofar as the formula for price is concerned, there is a certain logic to what Reliance has been paid. Legally speaking, the government of India many, many years ago, and many governments, whether it's Dev Gowda's government, the BJP government, or whether it's the Congress NDA government, sorry, the UPA government, all of them decided that the production sharing contract should be the basis for the relationship between a private contractor and the government. And in that production sharing contract, they made it very clear that the gas price would be related to the market.
Okay.
And they made that very clear. And they also stated that it would be subject to government approval.
Okay.
Now, what has happened is that they intervened and said that the price of gas will actually be administered by the government. And they leveled first a $4.20 price, and then they have now raised it to $8.
Yeah.
And this at a time when the import price of gas into India is $16. What few people seem to realize that Reliance is today buying gas from Shell. I was with Shell, so I know, and I negotiated this contract at $16 a million BTU to run their refineries. They could, under the contract, if that contract that they had with the government, they could have used their own gas and paid $14-$15, and they'd still be making some savings from the price that they're paying Shell right now.
All this
talk that we are currently engaged in detracts from one very simple fact, and that's the great irony. That the irony is today a company that is actually run by Aam Aadmi technocrats. So it's not as if Mukesh Ambani or anyone of that level went and found this gas in the Krishna Godavari basin. The people who found the gas were the people who were ex-ONGC, ex-OIL. We do not give them credit for having made the largest single discovery at that time in the world and having developed the gas from exploration to production in the shortest possible time that any international oil company
has done.
We don't give credit to our own Aam Aadmi technocrats. We are just simply criticizing.